Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we are going to be creating this habit tracker. Now, this habit tracker is a little bit special because in addition to calculating your daily progress, meaning the percentage of habits you complete per day and the percentage of habits that you complete for the entire month, as you can see on this side of the habit tracker, it also gives you a visual growing plant that responds to the percentage of habits you complete per day. Now, let's take a closer look at what that looks like. So right up here, you can see this plant at various stages of growth or development. And if we start clicking the different habits, so starting with July 1st, you can see right here that the plant grows from a tiny to a more developed version of the sunflower. If I go ahead and click on all of the boxes right here, you can see that it's now a full-grown sunflower. So every single column has this feature built into it. That's what we're going to be creating in today's tutorial. It is going to be a long video, but no worries, I will organize it into different chapters to make it easier for you to navigate through. Here is what we're going to be completing. We'll create the habit tracker table, the one we just saw. We'll add the formulas to the habit tracker to make sure they work correctly. Then we'll add the images to the template and connect those images to the formulas. As usual, this specific template, the one we create today, will be available in my Patreon. So if you want to support me, you can go ahead and join. Thank you to my current patrons for your support. And of course, I will have a link in the description box to a completed version that you can go ahead and purchase. But if you want to create it yourself, no worries. We'll go over every single step and all of the formulas you need to create this habit tracker. That being said, let's get started by creating a new sheet, add sheet. And what I'm going to do next is just clean it up and remove the extra rows and resize them. Now make this smaller and make this wider. This is where we're going to put in our task. Add some borders. So this would be the first header, the second one. This is a task area. So make a border around them. And then we're going to merge this cell and merge this one. And before I continue, I like to make sure that I change the font for everything. So I'm going to use this font style, align it center and change the text position to middle, and then add some headers. So this would be habits tracker. I'll just make this bigger. And of course you can change the style for the header. In this example, I used this one. This is inspiration. I'll go ahead and change that. Okay, inspiration, and make it bigger. And here I'm going to add a date picker option. So go to data validation, add rule, is valid dates, reject the input, done. Now if I double click, I can select a date, but what I want is for this to show up as the month and the year. So go to format, number, custom date and time. So I want it to show up as the month and year. So delete the day, remove the slashes in between, and I want the month as the full month and the year as the full year. Click apply. So here's what it looks like. Go back and change the formatting to add some space in between. Okay, right here, just add some space, click apply. All right, and then maybe make it bold. And now select this entire range, go to borders, change the internal borders to something lighter, horizontal borders, border style, select this option right here, change this border to an outline and call this daily habits. Okay, make this slightly bigger. All right, and this part is done. Next, we're gonna create this area right here. So we need 31 columns for the dates, one column for the percentage, and another column for the progress bar. Go back here, select all the columns. Now I'm gonna resize them by clicking on the last one and dragging to the left. All right, so now we have the columns a little smaller. You can always resize them by dragging to the left or to the right until it's the size you want. Okay, now I'm gonna add a few more columns. Now that we have this resized, we're gonna add borders. Select everything all the way through AG, okay? Add a border around them. Now I'll create the weekly sections. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, create a border there and then merge this first one. This would be week one. And these would be where the plants would go. So select everything here, go to merge, merge vertical. So each plant would be in each section right here. And then I'm gonna select these two and add a border around them and add a border around here. Add internal borders using this lighter version. So it looks like this. And do the same for this part. Now what we can do next is copy this. And now we're going to paste it for the rest of the week. So copy, paste here, paste, rename this week 2, week 3, week 4. And then this is the extra week. So manually merge. And this would be extra. Down here would be the daily progress percentages. the border there, and here would be the monthly percentages. So another border there, and then one more for the progress bar. Let's remove the grid lines to see what it looks like. If you want now, you can add some internal borders here, go back here, make sure this is selected, and then just copy the style and paste it for the rest of the weeks. Next, we're going to add some colors. And of course, this would vary based on your taste. I'll keep it simple by using the colors provided within the template. However, you can import your own colors and make it even more personalized. Next, we'll add some checkboxes. So select the entire section that we're going to add checkboxes into. Go to inserts, checkbox. All right. I like to make it a little bit smaller just so it doesn't look overcrowded. Now that we have our checkboxes in here, you can change the colors to match the color up here. So I'm going to select the first week. Go to text color, select this red right here, and do the same for the rest of the week. The next you want to do is to add some dates here. So I'm going to click on the first cell, equal, select this cell, okay, because we want it to start with the date that has been selected here. Click on enter. It shows up as July 2024, but we only want it to show up as a single date. So select the entire area, go to format, number, custom date and time. And now I'm going to select this one that says Tuesday, click up here and change it to day without leading zero and click apply. Okay, now it says one because the 1st of July is selected. If you don't want to start tracking your habits the first day of the month, let's say you want to start at the 14th, you have the flexibility to do so. For the subsequent days, we're going to add one to the cell before it. So now this would be equals this cell plus one, and this would be equals this cell plus one. And then you can just copy and paste. We want to do the same thing up here. So equals July, enter. And then for this section, we're going to select everything. Go back to format, number, custom date and time. Select Tuesday and make sure that it is the abbreviation. Okay. Click apply. And now it shows up as Monday in the shortened form. Equals this first day plus one. Now we can copy this and paste it for the rest of the week. For week two, we'll do the same, equals the previous stat plus one. And then we're going to just copy this and paste it for the rest of the week. Everything looks good. What we're going to do now is copy from week two, paste it in week three and week four. For the extra days, I'm going to copy this three right here. Okay, copy. And then instead of just pasting it, I'm going to right click, click on paste special, formula only. The reason I did this is because I don't want the format in here to change. Everything looks good. So if we test it one more time, everything works as it should. Next, I'm going to paste in some habits so that we can start creating the formulas to calculate the percentages. Okay, here are the habits we have, and you can keep it center justified or left justified, whatever you want. Okay, I'm going to change this to center justified for now and make this a little bit smaller. So this part is done. Next, we're going to add formulas to the habit tracker. The first formula is the formula to calculate the percentage of habits completed per day. All this is adding up the number of boxes checked, dividing it by the number of habits that we have available. So we're going to copy this formula. And of course, feel free to pause the video if you are creating this alongside with me. Go back here and now we're going to paste it here. We need to update the formula slightly. This goes all the way down to 26 in this template. So change this to 26 and change this to 26 as well. Click enter. Let's test it out to make sure it works by checking a few boxes. All right, so it looks like it's working fine. What we want displayed here is the percentage. So we're going to change the format in a little bit. So select the entire area, go up here and select format as percent. And now it is showing up as percentage, but we don't want the extra decimal places. So just click on this until it shows up as a percent without the decimals. And so it looks like it's working okay so far. The next thing we're going to do is to copy this formula for the entire month. Before we do this, I want to bring to your attention that this formula has been fixed. And the reason we do this is that when we copy and paste this formula, we do not want this column to move. For example, if I remove this dollar signs, the formula still works fine. But what happens when I try to copy it and paste it into the next cell? You can see that instead of counting the habits in this column, it moves it over to this column. We don't want it to do that. We always want the bottom to count the number of habits. So that should never change, which is why we use the dollar signs to fix the cells. Now we can go ahead and copy the formula, select the entire range, right click, and we want to paste special and place formula only. And we can test it out to make sure that it works. It looks like it's working. Next, we're going to calculate the progress per month. So taking the number of habits that we completed divided by the number of habits to complete. So it's a count if and a count a formula. And I'm just going to copy this and paste it here. Okay, now let's test it out. If I click this button, okay, so we have to reformat as we did before. So select the entire column, click on percentage, and remove the decimal places. Check all of them. That's 100%, so it works fine. Now we're going to do the same thing. Copy the formula, select the entire column, right-click, paste special, formula only. Okay, and here's what it looks like. Next, we're going to copy this formula right here. This is a sparkline formula. The one we're using in this habit tracker is the bar sparkline, and it allows you to track your progress, and it creates this progress bar feature. So the smaller the bar, the smaller the percent, the larger the bar, the larger the percent. So if we change this, check all of these boxes, it goes all the way to 100% and the spark bar completely fills up the space. So here's what the formula looks like. We'll start with sparkline. Select the cell that we're interested in. The chart type is bar. We want the maximum to be 1, which is 100. And we've added a specific color X code. So we don't want to use the specific X code. You can type in the color you want. We can change this to blue, for example. Enter. And the color is blue. So you can either do that or add in your own specific color. So it's more customized to exactly how you want it to show up. I'm going to copy this formula and paste it here. Now I'm just going to double check to make sure that it's selecting the right cell, which it is. Select the entire range, right click, paste special, formula only. Here's what it looks like. And if I start clicking in this specific habit, you can see that this percentage grows and the progress bar grows. The next I want to show you is to create this gradient effect. These colors are automatically selected based on the percentage. So the higher percentages are darker green and blue, and the lower percentages are red and yellow and orange. So this is a range that automatically calculates based on the percentage that's in this area. And this can be achieved using conditional formatting. So go back to our sheet. We're going to select this entire range, click on format, conditional formatting. And now we're going to use color scale. You can use whatever you want. Select an existing color range or change it to a range that suits your needs. Click done. All right. And then we're going to do the same for this area right here. Click on the entire column, add another rule, color scale, change it to whatever range you want. Click done. The next step is to add images to our template. Here are the images that I used. These are PNG images that I imported into the spreadsheet, and I'll show you how to do that in a second. I got these two images from Canva, and the rest of them I generated using Midjourney. We'll start by opening up a new sheet. All right. Just rename these images. I'm going to place the image here. So I'll make this row bigger. Click into the cell. Click on insert image. Make sure you select insert image in cell. Click on browse. And here are my images. Okay, I have 10 images that I downloaded into my computer. So I'll start by clicking on the first one and just repeat the steps until all of the images have been imported into your sheet. Now I have all my images loaded into the sheet. Next, we need to connect this sheet to our habit tracker. We're going to grab the formula from the sheet, but before I do that, I'm going to show you how the formula works. The formula is going to reference the sheet with the images. What the formula is doing is that it's going to reference that cell where the image is, and it's going to place an image based on the percentage here. So for example, if C22 is 0, do nothing. If C22 is between 0 and 20%, the first image. If C22 is less than 30%, add this image, and so on and so forth. So what we're doing is giving it the entire range, giving it a certain cell, and using that as a reference to select the correct image. That's all this formula is. Now I'm going to go back to my sheet, paste the formula here. All right, and now it is referencing my original image file, which is fine, but just to show you that if your tab is named something different, just go ahead and change the name of images here to the one that matches where your image is located. And the other thing that I have to change is the location of the cell. So instead of C22, it has to be C27. So go ahead and change that, and it works fine. Now we can copy this, select the entire range, right-click, paste, formula only. Let's test it out to make sure it works the way it's supposed to. So click more. So it changes right here at 30%. So let's see, at 40%, we have this one. 55% it changes. Click on all of them at once and check all the boxes. They should all show up as grown. So we know that they work the way they're supposed to. And these two steps are done. And finally, let's rename this tracker July 2024. We can copy it, duplicate, rename this August 2024, enter, and then change this date to August 1st. Now we're going to uncheck all the boxes at once. To do this, select the entire range in the template, tap the space button on your keyboard once, it selects everything, tap it one more time, it clears everything. Now we have copy of August, just rename this as September, and you can keep duplicating this template as you need it. All right, so that brings me to the end of this tutorial. I hope you learned something. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. If you are a member of my Patreon, you will get this template as well as the image, so you can go ahead and play around with it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.